you know, we had the supermoon earlier this month. And then this weekend's anticipated solar eclipse, we're getting quite the show in the skies this month. This is a shot of that supermoon if you missed it, but goodness, for stargazers, it's going to be a fun Sunday night.
Yeah, it is like a celestial extravaganza, and we're talking about the best way to see the solar eclipse. Dirk Verdoorn joins us for more on this. Hey, Dirk, I talked to my mother. She lives in northern Arizona in this little town. Mm-hmm. Apparently one of the best places to see this. Every hotel room is booked in the entire town. That's what she told me.
A lot of peaks.
This place is going to be a great place to see it as well. Sacramento, it's going to be okay. You want to go a little bit more north, just north of Marysville, Yuba City. You're going to have great viewing there. But there's two things you want to remember this weekend is that there's two don'ts you want to remember. And the first thing is don't miss this eclipse. It's going to be spectacular. And the second thing is don't look at the sun. You don't want to directly look at it with the naked eye. And so what do you do in a situation where you want to see it, but you can't look at it? Well, you can make something like this. This is a pinhole camera. And what I did is I just took a bunch of stuff that was laying around here, the station and the backstage and that, and I made a pinhole camera. I have a cover here on the front. You can see the little pinhole at the tip of the lens there. There actually is no lens, but that's the tip of the cover. And then what I have is you have to have a dark place to view it. And so what happens is the light of the sun comes through, and then it goes into this chamber here, and I've got a white piece of paper on the backdrop there, and that's where it shows up. It ends up being a little bit bigger than the size of a quarter, but that's what you're going to be able to view the eclipse with. There's other ways to view the eclipse as well, though, and I'm going to be showing a few more of those simpler methods. You may not want to make something so elaborate as this, but there's other ways you can view it, and one of the best ways actually is just tuning in to KCRA and watching the coverage. We're actually going to have extended coverage. Peak viewing is going to be around 6:30. We're going to have our newscast extend from 6:30 to 7 o'clock, and we'll give you all the information and a lot more coming up this Sunday, again, is when it's going to be taking place.